Tray tables and seat backs are upright and locked and all carrying.
I haven't done this in a while, and I'm very excited because I'm gonna be actually doing this, talking about a project that is about to happen in like 3 days. I just wanted to come on here and share a little bit more about what this project is all about. Let's begin. It's actually been months since I've done a more of a chit chat video. I've actually been working on different blogs, but I haven't done what I did in my first video, which was a storytelling type of video. But now I'm here and I am back with something sort of similar to that type of style, and I'm just really happy that I'm able to talk about a project that I've been working on for months now. And now I am only 3 days away from actually starting this project, and I feel just very, very happy and content and very excited and ready to start this adventure. And of course, it's gonna be a lot of work. It's gonna be long days, so full on working, and I'm totally okay with that. And the idea behind it and the purpose that I hope we're able to meet with the mural project in Tijuana really make it all worth it. So before I begin, let me introduce myself for anyone who is visiting my channel for the first time. Welcome, my name is Lisbela Cruz Santana. I am a PhD candidate at UC Davis, and I'm about to start my fourth year in just a few months, and I'm very thankful that I've made it this far. Hopefully, if everything goes to plan and things just align, I'll be done in 2 years, and then I'll be Dr. De La Cruz Santana, which is one of my goals in regards to my career. But let's talk about the Playas de Tijuana mural project. And I feel like I always get super excited when I talk about it, because it has been a project that has been in the back burner for like many, many years. And it all started in 2016, the first year that I was able to go back to Tijuana now as an adult. So I actually went there with the Humanizing Deportation team for training at El Cole, because we were gonna start doing field work in the summer of that next year. So my first visit to Playas de Tijuana, like ever, was in November 2016, and I remember that night clearly. The team visited different places in Tijuana, and Playas was one of them, so we were actually gonna have dinner there. And a lot of our field work in 2017 actually was made possible through the space in Friendship Park. But to keep it short, for me, Playas became this space and where people could claim their voices and take ownership of what they want the space to actually be. So to further on why the idea of the mural. So in that same summer of 2017, I spent a lot of time looking at this wall almost every day. So I do have a lot of moments that have marked my experience there. One of the top ones for me has been Father's Day in that same summer, and just to see people coming from different places from Mexico to see their loved ones, people traveling days just to see their family members who are in the US for a super small limited amount of time. So growing up in Fresno has actually provided a lot of inspiration behind the work that I do now, and the mural is not an exception. During my time at Fresno State, I picked up this tradition with a few of my friends to head out to Fresno's Art Hop, which is hosted every first Thursday of each month. Art Hop for me set in motion a lot of different projects. As the president of Club Austral in Fresno State, which is a Spanish club at the university, I was able to coordinate a series of cultural nights and different events that involved the community, the Mexican consulate, and different businesses in the Central Valley. And I remember I was coordinating my first Art Hop, and I went out to Chinatown with one of my friends to check out a venue that we were super interested in. And previously I had heard about an artist in the Central Valley who was really well known, specifically with my friends, and I was able to see a lot of his work in Art Hop, specifically around Fresno. While driving around, you would see different murals and some of his work that was on display in one of the venues that hosted Art Hop. In our visit to this venue, I ran into Mauro Carrera and invited him to be part of a cultural night. He said yes, and he was all about it. After that, I just became more of a huge fan. Once I was already out in Davis, we invited him over to paint a piece for one of the groups out there in the Spanish department called DIG. He had a really great session with the students in the Spanish department, and we still have his artwork in one of our rooms. So that's when this idea came about. I remember I messaged Mauro and I told him like, hey, I am super interested in doing this project in Tijuana. I'm gonna look for funds and we're gonna make this happen. Are you on board? And again, he was on board. I feel like maybe a year and a half passed by since we had that conversation. I submitted an application to be part of the 2019 Mellon Public Scholars at UC Davis with the intention to work digital narratives again this summer for humanizing deportation. So fortunately, I got this fellowship. I was and I'm still very happy and I'm just overall thankful that the university and these programs continue to believe in the work that I attempt to do. It just makes it all just more rewarding. So one of the requirements to get this fellowship was to take a seminar with all the fellows, a professor, and then Stephanie, who is the coordinator of the program. And let me tell you that I started this class feeling very, very nervous and not knowing what to expect. I've hardly taken classes outside my department, and in the classes that I've taken outside my department, there was always a familiar face there, maybe someone from my program taking a similar class. This was a first-time experience. I've learned so much and apply a lot of the things that we saw in this seminar to my project. And it was in one of the assignments that we had to do that I decided that I needed to do this project, that the mural project was something that I wanted to do, that this fellowship was gonna be the only opportunity I was gonna have to work on the mural project, because we had this freedom of creativity to do an engaged project with the community and to connect people from both sides of the border. And for me, that was just as a gift sent to me, and I need to make sure I do this. And I set this in motion. So before proceeding, I remember I messaged Mauro, I was like, hey, I have funds, let's do this. So now we are here, and I was also fortunate enough to be able to find an advisor who also believed in this project and the vision that I have for the mural project. So towards the middle of the spring quarter of this year, I felt like things were falling into place, things were all running smooth. I had my muralist who was gonna go paint with me in Tijuana, which was Mauro Carrera. So part of my job as a director for this mural project is to make sure that our budget is set. So a big part of my fellowship will be going into funding this project. During this time, I had to find our lodging, and thankfully my friend Felipe letting us borrow his apartment, which I'm internally grateful for this. Additionally, I had to book flights to San Diego, transportation, making sure the materials get ordered. Additionally, I also booked a videographer with the hopes to obtain drone footage for a documentary that I'm also working on for this project, which I will not talk about in this video for right now because it's something that I really want to keep to myself, in the sense that I have really high hopes for this documentary and I know it's going to be great. And I just wanted to be super like a surprise for everyone. So it's gonna be my first official documentary. I did do a little warm up earlier this year for a festival that was hosted in San Diego. So before giving you a list of all the different things that go into place of being the director and public relations person, just easier to say that it just demands a lot of time, dedication, seriousness. The intention of this project is to bring light to the myriad of stories behind the childhood arrivals dilemma in the U.S. to inform people of what is going on in regards to deportations and the experiences of those that fall vulnerable to deportation. I also want people to be able to see and associate art as a political tool. So this is my way of bridging the arts, academia, the community, and activism in one by showcasing stories in the Humanizing Deportation Archive and DACAmented Dreams Without Borders. And I'm super excited to see the final result. We aim to finish on August 9th. So I can't really imagine how that's gonna feel, but I do know that I'm gonna feel a sense of relief, just a lot of joyfulness. I guess that's the perfect word for it. So if you made it this far to the video, thank you for watching. Thank you for even taking interest in this project. I will leave down in the description box the Facebook like page for the Playas de Tijuana Mural project. And if you give it a like, you're gonna be able to see all the updates and posts, our calendar, our flyer, and just overall information that goes behind this artivism. And I also have a website tab for the project in my digital portfolio. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I tried my best to make it as chronological as possible, as if I was telling a story. So this was just basically a background look into how this project came to be, and I feel very blessed to have this opportunity. So we'll see how it all goes, and I'm very hopeful that it's gonna work out. And before I end this video, I want to give a huge thanks to Leopoldo Peña, who took several of the portraits for Humanizing Deportation. And I also want to thank my advisor Robert for sharing these with me. So I want to give a huge thank you to my friend John for allowing me to take a picture of him and to use that same image for the mural. To Monse for showing the faces of the real dreamer moms. I also want to thank Carla Estrada. I really admire all the work that she does for the community. I also want to thank Andy, and I really wanted to show his story because he's a deported veteran, a childhood arrival who made his life in the Central Valley. And I also want to thank Kaido, because every time I reach out to him for all these ideas that I have, either with using his music and working with me with the DACAmented project and now with the Humanizing Deportation project, I feel like he's always on board and he doesn't hesitate and he understands the vision, and I really, really appreciate that. So a big, huge thank you to him. And to the other narrators who are gonna be with us in Playas de Tijuana, I'll see you guys in a few days. I also wanna thank Enrique Bravo for sponsoring stickers with the mural design, which we will be giving out in Tijuana and once we come back to the US. So that's another of the cool collaborations that we have going on. And a huge thank you to Enrique Chiu for letting us borrow his studio in Casa del Tune. I'm gonna wrap this up. Thank you for watching. And if you are new to my channel and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it, subscribe. And if anyone has any questions or inquiries or comments, you could either email me directly and I'll put my email down here and also in the description box. You could also message me directly in the Facebook like page. Thank you for your time, and we will be seeing each other again pretty soon, and hopefully with the entire mural ready to show. That's all for today, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.